So when using your Mac, you've got a lot of control over your environment. And one of the pieces of the environment that you have control over is the dock. That's the row of icons at the bottom of your screen. You can decide whether or not you want them to always be there or whether you want them to hide and show automatically. I found out recently a lot of Mac users don't realize you can control this. And when they find out there's the other option, they like that a lot better. So here we see the dock in the state where it's always there. If I move my cursor up higher on the screen, it's still there. If I'm using an app, like here I am in Pages, the dock is still there. A lot of people like this because you can always see what apps are there. You can see which ones are running because it's got a dot under it. And you can quickly and easily access them. But the disadvantage is it takes up some screen space. So if I go to drag this window down here, you see I can only really drag it down to the top of the dock. If I option click the plus button there, it hits the top of that dock there. Now for a lot of screens this may not make much of a difference, but on some smaller MacBooks that could be actually quite a lot of screen space. So you can change this behavior. If you go to System Preferences and you go to the dock, you can turn on Automatically Hide and Show the Dock. Now you can see the dock just went away, but it's still there. All I need to do is move my cursor to the bottom of the screen and it pops up and appears. So I still have the same access because I can't click on those icons if my cursor is up here. So I move down to the bottom, it appears, and I select which app I want to switch to. But I can also click and drag the bottom of the window all the way down to the bottom there. And you can see it actually gives me a lot more space. The dock will still appear over it, but now I've got that little bit extra bit of space for that window. And when I use the green button there with the option key, it also takes up that space. This can be good. A lot of people like the extra screen space. They like the dock to be hidden away until they need it. But a disadvantage is that a lot of times you go to the bottom of this window to do something, and instead of actually getting to do it, like I want to click down here to actually take care of something, you move a little bit too far and the dock pops up. So it can be a little frustrating sometimes at the bottom of the screen with your cursor because the dock's there. But the important thing is to realize that both of these options are there. It's easy to use System Preferences to switch between them. You can also get to these preferences very easily in the dock by control clicking on the line there. And you can not only go to preferences, but you can turn hiding off and on. So control click, turn hiding off and on. There are other ways to do it as well. But that's a quick way to play around with it and see if you like it one way or the other. Thank you.